All right, Meg White with the White Stripes, Seven Nation Army. It's built on a great guitar riff, and Meg is all about the quarter note here. We've talked about 4-4 and the fact that that C at the beginning of the time signature means there's four beats to the measure. Quarter note gets the beat. And most of what Meg's doing in this piece is driving that quarter note. She's doing it with three limbs, whereas in Satisfaction, we had a three-limb beat where the hi-hat with the stick, the snare drum, and the bass drum had to be really synchronized. Here we have the floor tom with the right hand, the bass drum, and the left foot. So make sure you get that really synchronized so you can drive the quarter note. You don't want any kind of flams. You want to be unified and driving this thing with a solid quarter note. So you want to count and feel those subdivisions so that when you're playing, those quarter notes are driving at a real steady pace. That'll drive the music better. So if you're counting 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and, right? So then you'll feel the quarter note stronger. You'll notice on the third stave that four limbs have to synchronize because Meg brings in the backbeat on 2 and 4. That sounds like this. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. Right? Building the groove up a little bit. And then on the fourth stave, she brings a cymbal crash in. She does that with her left hand so she can keep that floor tom going. That sounds like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right? And then in the next line, she goes into actually the same groove that Phil Rude was playing in Back in Black, which is 1 and 3 on the bass drum. 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And 2 and 4 on a snare drum. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. But instead of that hi-hat pattern with eighth notes that Phil was playing, she's playing the crash cymbal of quarter notes, again, driving the quarter note. So that sounds like this. 1, 2, and 3, and 4. Right? Then, after three measures into that, there's that little syncopated pattern that happens. Again, we got to break it down in the 16th notes to feel this. That pattern sounds like this. I'll do it for you slowly. 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1. I'll do it again. 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1. So let's back it up and take it a little bit before, or two measures before the cymbal crash comes in, and play right through that pattern. So this is the middle of the fourth stave of music. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 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 get everything synchronized, drive the quarter note groove strongly by feeling smaller subdivisions, and you know, listen to the music, also listen to the song, the way Meg plays it, listen to that guitar riff, how they fit together. All right, have fun.